NuttyItOnline.com/LiveWire.
Hypothetical Thursday, Joe Robinson is here. Hello, sir.
What's going on, man?
We have Lowell Melzer in here on news. And, yeah, we're turning it over to the listeners for our hypothetical, letting them suggest some things.
So far, I haven't had my socks knocked off.
Here we go with another one. If you were exiled from America, completely prohibited from contacting anyone in the United States, you had to choose a new country to live in, meet new people, get a new job, everything. Where would you go?
I would go to Canada. Because it's as
America light.
It's as much like America as you could possibly get.
Right.
And they're so much friendlier up there.
Just go to Toronto.
Yeah.
No, Montreal.
Oh, ooh, yeah. Yeah. That's right. What about you?
I was thinking Montreal. Then, of course, the other easy answer is England.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, they speak the language.
Yeah, but the chicks are hotter, I think. Well, maybe not in Canada. I don't know. They're hotter in America.
And then part of me has the whole, you know, romantical side of it where you're like, just
tropical.
Go to Italy and just learn the culture and become and just, you know, just completely submerge yourself in everything.
I mean, and the food and yeah. Sorry,
producer Mike here. Without a doubt, South Korea, where half of them already speak.
Without a doubt,
they already speak English. That's like their second language and. Technologically, they're like a couple years ahead of us. I mean, it's a no-brainer.
That's what.
Not to mention, you know, you're like an alien there. I mean, you're so much more appealing to the women there because you're probably taller.
Yeah,
right.
And yeah, you're so like super exotic. Super.
Well,
exotic.
They love you there. Yeah,
that's a good point. I didn't think about that.
Sure.
God, he's a genius.
And they treat their men nicer in the Asian culture.
That's true.
Right?
They and they'll walk behind you.
Yeah.
And they won't bug you.
Food head down.
Food's wonderful.
God, you're a genius.
They're not always yammering.
Right.
Oh yeah. Okay. I hear you, Mike.
He's so smart. Hottest girl in the world with the nastiest personality. This is for the rest of your life. Would you rather be with the hottest girl in the world with the nastiest personality or a really ugly girl with a great personality? And this is you have to live with them for the rest of your life.
Yeah, I don't care about your personality. I'll just hang out with you. I don't need a girl to have a great personality.
Yeah, but if you want to go out to a bar and you want to go out to dinner and yeah, you got this great arm candy. And you're bringing her around with you everywhere you go, but you just can't stand her. You want to like punch her in the face after
but
a while.
But he said the
other
one,
which I don't condone, by the way.
Is ugly. You saw it. He didn't say, you know, she's a five. She's ugly. You understand? You can't be out with an ugly chick.
Yeah, but she's the greatest person inside.
Well, okay.
You have to think long term because I'll tell you, what good is having an expensive sports car if it's always in the shop?
Uh-huh.
Well,
that's a great analogy.
Yeah. Can she get hit the gym? Can she get her teeth? Can she get veneers?
No.
She can't.
She's got to stay
ugly.
Nose
job, chin job. She can't do that?
No.
Botox?
No.
I think in the long run, you'd be happier because you'd have someone you could spend the rest of your life with and be happy.
Joe's very superficial.
I am very
shallow.
Superficial. I
very
am
shallow.
Yeah. I'm definitely going with the hot chick.
All right. This one seems very, very, I think we know the answer. Would you rather discover your spouse is having an affair or is gay?
Gay.
Oh, I don't care. I'm not bothered by either.
But which would affect you less or more? If you find out they're gay, they were born that way. It's
not a
decision.
That's what I'm saying.
Right.
If you find out they're having an affair, they've like destroyed
they've
your whole foundation.
They've made a conscious decision that they don't like you and you're not good in bed and they want to move on.
And I understand that, but if they're gay, I'm like, how stupid am I that this is my wife.
That's a good
and she's
point.
Been gay? And that says a lot about, that says even more about
me. Yeah, that's a good point.
Then I'm like, I didn't understand why she was going to all these WNBA games, and I didn't understand why she had a mullet. Well, I didn't. And
how did I not?
I couldn't see it.
You knew.
How did I not know?
You knew.
Mythological creatures, if they existed today, which one would be the coolest, and which one would suck the most?
Well, dragon is clearly the best.
That's what I thought.
I'm
like a flying
better
dragon.
Better than a unicorn?
No, that's the worst. It's
no,
galloping
but here's
around
the thing.
Prancing.
Flying dragon that breathes fire is effing awesome. Clearly the best. But is it also the worst because will it now pose a threat to your everyday life?
Yeah, it'll ruin your life. Whereas the unicorn.
It's not cool. Is the great white shark cool? Is the polar bear cool? Something that would consider you prey if you were still cool.
But
by the way, we're man. We would harness these things.
You would
and
like
we
to
would,
think. You
yeah,
would
we'd
like
have
to
them
think.
In cages. Yeah, we could. We'd dominate that.
Well, how do you not know that there'll be like now EAS alerts for dragons.
We'd it won't be with trank guns.
It won't be an Amber Alert. It'll be like a whatever alert.
No.
Just, and everybody's got to flee to their homes because
see what
there's
happened?
A dragon flying around the city.
Did you see what happened in the latest Godzilla movie?
Right.
I mean, we can't control them.
No, that's we'd hit that. Well, Godzilla's big as a skyscraper. If a dragon, you just assume it's as big as a, I don't know, like an elephant in the air.
No, they're like bigger than a,
they're
than a jet.
Well, they're make believe. We make them as big as we pretend them to be.
I would
right?
say like a dragon, the way I sit it in my head, is like at least two school buses.
Well, we could shoot
least.
Them down. If
I
they
think
became,
it's like a 777.
That
like bigger, yeah.
Mm.
If they became too threatening, we would.
Eradicate them,
yeah. But we'd eventually find a way to trank them. They'd live in our zoos. We'd be fine.
Yeah, I think we would.
Burning the...
Which one would suck the most? I mean, who knows? I don't know.
Goat man?
Oh, the goat man.
Oh, the Pegasus.
Pegasus is
cool.
Centaur would be good, too.
Centaur.
All right, let's wrap it up.
I'm still saying the unicorn's good, because isn't everything they touch turns to gold or something? I don't know.
No, you're confusing your mythological creatures.
Rumpelstiltskin.
One last phone call. Adrian, what's up?
Hey, what's up? Good morning.
Morning.
I'm the notion about the hot girl with a terrible attitude and the ugly girl with the great attitude.
Great personality,
yeah. I have to go with the hot chick.
Yeah.
Because, you know, once you bring her out to the bar, she'd be annoying and everything, but everyone would know, like, well, she's hot, and that's why they're together, and that's why he's with her.
But he amended it saying, you said that she's a hot girl with a terrible attitude. That's what I have right now.
And you're okay with it?
Right, I'm perfectly fine with it.
The 98 Rock Morning Show with Justin Scott and Spiegel. 98online.com.